distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to call to the stage Dr. Torre and Ambassador Lorenzo so that we may present the final tribute of the evening. On behalf of the South South Awards, it is our privilege tonight to honor the careers of President Nelson Mandela with a Humanitarian Achievement Award. And Madame Graca Machel with a Humanitarian Achievement Recognition.
Nelson Mandela, a worldwide leader and symbol of the global struggle for peace, human rights, and development. He joined the African National Congress in 1944, serving in numerous offices. On August 5th, 1962, he was arrested and sentenced to 5 years in prison. While he was serving this sentence, he was charged with sabotage. In 1964, he and seven others were sentenced to life imprisonment. Mandela served 27 years in prison, 18 years on Robben Island off the coast of Cape Town, before he was transferred to Polesmore Prison on the mainland. He was released on February 11, 1990, at the age of 71. In 1991, he was elected the leader of the unbanned ANC, and in 1993, he won the Nobel Peace Prize, together with South African President F.W. de Klerk, for their efforts to bring about a peaceful settlement in South Africa. Then, on April 27, 1994, South Africa held its first elections with universal suffrage, marking the end of apartheid. Nelson Mandela was elected president with nearly two-thirds majority vote. He married Graca Machel in 1998, and the next year fulfilled his promise of only serving 1 year as president. He has dedicated his post-presidential life to charity. He founded the Nelson Mandela Foundation and the Nelson Mandela Children's Fund. He also set up the Mandela Rhodes Foundation that provides scholarships for postgraduate studies for promising African students. The United Nations celebrates Nelson Mandela Day annually on July 18th, President Mandela's birthday. Madame Graca Machel is a compassionate advocate for education and culture, as well as a devoted advocate for her continued global efforts for women and children. Born in Portuguese-occupied Mozambique, she studied in Lisbon. Upon her return in 1973, she joined the Front for the Liberation of Mozambique and was appointed Minister of Education and Culture in 1975. Under her leadership, Mozambique's literacy rates climbed to be the highest in Africa, and school attendance increased dramatically. During the 1980s and 90s, she worked for numerous development causes, including UNESCO's National Commission in Mozambique and the Foundation for Community Development addressing poverty in Mozambique. Madame Machel's work on children in conflict led to the groundbreaking UN study on the impact of armed conflict on children. She continues her tireless work for Africa and the world. Her responsibilities have included the UN High-Level Panel on the Post-2015 Agenda, the Partnership for Maternal, Newborn, and Child Health, and the African Center for the Constructive Resolution of Disputes. Together with President Mandela, Madame Machel started Legacy of Hope in 2012. An initiative resulting in the Nelson Mandela Children's Hospital, which aims to bring accessible and free health care to the children of Southern Africa.
Now, to accept these honors on behalf of President Mandela and Madame Machel, Ms. Zinzi Mandela and Ms. Joshina Machel, please come to the stage.
Thank you. On behalf of my father, we are humbled by your recognition of the role that he has played as a champion of human rights for South Africans, Africans, and the global community. My father says, the basic human rights for all our citizens have to be protected and guaranteed to ensure the genuine liberty of every individual. Thank you.
On behalf of my mom, I would like to thank you very much for this award. People like my mom and papa do not believe in words such as no, cannot be done, impossible. Rather, they create, they recreate, they innovate, and they continue on their path, doesn't matter what. Tonight, Mom's thoughts are definitely with the people of Kenya. If she was here tonight, she would humbly accept this award, but she would dedicate to the millions of women and children in Africa and in the entire globe, whose humanitarian efforts continue to sustain our human existence, but whose voices are rarely heard and whose achievements are rarely acknowledged. So for all those, I'd like to say thank you.
Raised by her widowed mother in a Soweto township, Yvonne Chaka Chaka went on to become Africa's most beloved female singer and is known throughout the world as the Princess of Africa.
For the past 30 years, Yvonne Chaka Chaka has lent her voice to effect change. Her first commitment was to the abolition of apartheid. And after that, she has fought tirelessly to improve the lives of women and children in the African continent.
As founder of the Princess of Africa Foundation and UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador Against Malaria, she enjoys a close relationship with our father, Nelson Mandela, and his wives, Winnie Mandela and Graca Machel. So, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the Princess of Africa, Yvonne Chaka Chaka.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, Mr. Mandela and his wives and his children.
He's an amazing man, given to us by God. He taught us to love, be free. Rainbow Nation, Holy Shaka Madiba Mandela. All the people in the world would give anything to touch you, even those who are caught in terrorism. Holy Shaka Madiba Mandela.
my latest album dedicated to the men of the world. Thank you to the Chakra Entertainment. Everybody now, we're taking it back home now. Come on and sing. Come now. Any African who knows the song now?
You wanna go back?